Our machine out of Whiteville, Tennessee, the Rowan Racing Rocket for Jonathan Rowan. Outside row one in car number 52 out of Seymour, Tennessee, Brian King Roofing Stinger for Ryan King. Row two on the inside in car number 18 out of Benton, Kentucky, in the Mertco Incorporated Special, Tate Davenport. Outside row two in car number 17H, Matt Hendrick, the Mighty Muffler and Brakes CVR. Row three on the inside in the 007 car to be Roger Best out of Maryville, Tennessee, in the Young Motorsports Warrior. Outside row three in car number 71, Brian Courtney out of Knoxville, Tennessee, Quality Machine and Welding CVR. Row four on the inside, the 19 Emma Josh Atkins out of Talladega, Alabama, the Yellowhammer Construction Special. Outside row four in the 8A, Todd Morrow, East Ridge, Tennessee, A-plus Collision Center GRT. Row five on the inside, the 121 car to be Michael Blunt out of Summerall, Mississippi, the Lamar Auto Salvage Track Star. Outside row five, car number 23, Barry Anderson out of Andrews, North Carolina, the Andrews Heating and Cooling Special. And in row six, in car number seven, William Overby out of Norris, Tennessee, in the O&B Racing Special. Field's been given the one-to-go signal. Everything looks good. We'll go green next time around. They've been given their starting instructions. The pole sitter can start the race when he gets inside the starting box in turn four between that last U tire and the orange cone. Field bunching up in turn three as they approach the starting box in turn number four. They're in it. They're on it. Green flag's out. We're racing. Side by side into turn number one up on the outside. It'll be Ryan King grabbing the lead in car number 52. Jonathan Rowan settles into the second spot. Side by side battle for third. Down the front straightaway, taking over that third spot. It'll be Matt Henderson in the 17H car. Around Tate Davenport in the 18 who runs fourth. Davenport will now get a challenge on the inside from the 71 car, Brian Courtney. And contact on the front straightaway between Courtney and Davenport. Davenport slides across the track into the infield to bring out the caution flag. In the books, eight to go. Ryan King, your race leader in car number 52. Jonathan Rowan, car number 56, holding on the outside as the field doubles up behind race leader Ryan King with two laps in the books. Top eight finishers will go on to the main event. Ryan King can restart the race anywhere he wants to in turn four by picking up the throttle. He's in the gas, green flag's out, we're racing. Rowan and Henderson battle for second. Henderson climbs the banking in turn two. Rowan ducks underneath. He'll bring Tate Davenport with him in the 18 car. Davenport up to third. Henderson sideways off of turn four. Todd Morrow slide underneath for fourth. Caution flag out on the speedway. Three cars tangle up over in turn number three. A Barry Anderson involved. Field doubled up behind the race leader, Ryan King. Two down, eight to go. B main number one for the D. Smith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series. Top eight finishers go on to the big show tonight. Ryan King brings him off the fourth turn, picks up the throttle, green flags out. Tate Davenport looking to the inside of Matt Henderson as they battle for the third spot, and Davenport spins in turn four. Caution flag coming out on the speedway. The 23, rather, of Barry Anderson involved. The speedway will be looking to go green next time by Ryan King, your race leader, with Jonathan Rowan in second, Matt Henderson running in the third spot, Roger Best fourth. Fifth is Todd Morrow. Sixth will be Josh Atkins. Seventh is Michael Blunt. Green flags back out. We're racing. Henderson climbs the banking again in turn two. Here comes Morrow to the inside. Morrow will drive underneath Matt Henderson to take over the third spot. Ryan King out in front, Jonathan Rowan second, Todd Morrow third, Matt Henderson in fourth. Roger Best running fifth. Michael Blunt and Brian Courtney battling for the sixth spot. Josh Atkins in eighth. Jake Davenport running in ninth. First driver on the outside looking in. Five laps down, five to go. Just past the halfway point of our first 10 lap B main. Ryan King still showing the way in car number 52. Looking for that seventh starting spot in the main event. Jonathan Rowan second, Todd Morrow third. Matt Henderson fourth, Roger Best running in the fifth spot. Josh Atkins in seventh. Michael Blunt in eighth. Tate Davenport running in ninth. First driver on the outside looking in. White flag in the air. One lap to go. Ryan King. Off of turn two, down the back straightaway. Checkered flag coming out, this time by Ryan King takes the win. It'll be Jonathan Rowan second, Todd Morrow third, Matt Henderson in fourth. Fifth will go to Roger Best. Sixth is Brian Courtney. Seventh is Josh Atkins. Michael Blunt in eight. And Tate Davenport will finish ninth, but he will get a provisional. As he's the second driver in line for provisional, we'll just have to wait to see if Ronnie Johnson races his way in. Here's the way they'll line up, going from the pole position in car number 88 out of Maryville, Tennessee, the CDE Electric Warrior for Brad Coffey. Outside the front row, the Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series point leader from Forest, Virginia, the Cecil B. Arthur Beef Farm Special for Walker Arthur. Second row on the inside in car number 5, the defending Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series National Champion, out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, in the Neesmith Chevrolet Special, the Chattanooga Flash, Ronnie Johnson. Outside row 2, Carly, Tennessee, the Greg Sawmill Special for Ashley Newman. Row 3 on the inside, Rookie of the Year point leader in the 56 end car out of Rainbow City, Alabama, the Old Man's Garage Special for Chris Noah. Outside row 3, car number 36, Evan Taylor out of Clarksville, Tennessee, the Elite Motor Special. Row 4 on the inside, car number 51, currently third in the points, Mac McCarter out of Gatlinburg, Tennessee, the CVR Race Cars House Car. Outside row 4, the 17W, it'll be Brett Wyatt out of Crossville, Tennessee, in the Wyatt Builder Special. In row 5, on the inside, in car number 35, Todd Kaufman out of Parksville, Kentucky, the Kaufman Photography Rocket. And rounding out the field on the outside of row 5, in car number 17, out of Corinth, Mississippi, the Dunn Motorsports Special for Ronald Dunn. That's your starting lineup. B main number 2, 10 laps in length. Top 8 go on to the main event. Field's been given the one to go signal and their starting instructions. They'll go green when the pole sitter, Brad Coffey, gets inside the starting box in turn 4. Field bunching up in turn number 3. Coffey approaches the starting box. They're in it, they're on it. Green flags out, we're racing. Brad Coffey grabs the lead in turn 1. They'll go 3 wide for second. Ronnie Johnson inside of Walker Arthur down the back straightaway. He's got Ashley Newman with him in the 73 car down on the bottom. Caution flag coming out on the speedway. Got one in the Ute tire at the head of the back straightaway. Attention in the pit area. Street stocks, bring them to staging. Street stocks, bring them to staging. Street stocks, bring them to staging. Getting set for the restart. Brad Coffey, Walker Arthur. Hit the starting box. Green flags out. Once again, it's Brad Coffey out in front. Ronnie Johnson gets to the inside of Walker Arthur. Down the back straightaway. Ronnie Johnson will take over that second spot. Point leader Walker Arthur now battling with Ashley Newman for the third spot. Brad Coffey still showing the way with Ronnie Johnson second, Walker Arthur third, Ashley Newman in the fourth spot. Three wide for fifth, and Wyatt gets together. Caution flag is out. Chris Noah escaped that three wide tangle. And Mac McCarter in the 51 lock horns and slide to the infield. Johnson, the defending champion. Walker Arthur, the current point leader. Field doubled up behind race leader Brad Coffey. Two laps in the books. Getting set to go back to green. Eight to go. Trouble on the front straightaway. Several cars tangling up on the front stretch. Mac McCarter involved in the 51. The 17, a Ronald Dunn in the 36. Of Evan Taylor tangling up down the front straight. Green flags out. Brad Coffey and Ronnie Johnson pulling away from the third place car, Walker Arthur. Ashley Newman still riding fourth. Fifth is Chris Noah. Caution flag coming out on the speedway. The 36 car speeding once again down the front straightaway. Evan Taylor. Field doubled back up. Five laps in the books, five to go, right at the halfway point of our second 10 lap B main. Brad Coffey picks up the pace. Green flag in the air. Caution flag coming out. Ronald Dunn in the 17 car spins and collects the 36 car of Evan Taylor. And we'll try it again, this time by five down, five to go. Brad Coffey out in front, Ronnie Johnson second, Walker Arthur in third. Picking up the pace off of turn four, green flags out. Still leading Ronnie Johnson. Walker Arthur in third, Ashley Newman fourth. Chris Noah fifth, Brett Wyatt sixth. Seventh is Mac McCarter, eighth is Todd Coffin. Ronald Dunn, first driver on the outside, looking in the ninth spot in car number 17. Evan Taylor running 10th in the 36 car. White flag in the air, one lap to go. We got a spin in turn two. It looks like he's gonna keep going. So we remain under green, and now they bring the caution out. Mac McCarter, Todd Kaufman running in the eighth spot in car number 35. Green flags out. White flag in the air, one lap to go. Brad Coffey, car number 88, comes down for the checkered flag. Your winner, Ronnie Johnson second, Walker Arthur third, Ashley Newman fourth, and fifth will go to Chris Noah in the 56 end car. Coming home in the sixth spot, Brent Wyatt in the 17W machine. Seventh will be Mac McCarter in the 51 car. Starting 24th tonight in car number 36 out of Clarksville, Tennessee, in the Elite Motor Special, it'll be Evan Taylor. Going 23rd in car number 18, finished third in the point standings last year out of Benton, Kentucky, in the Mertco Incorporated Special, Tate Davenport. Starting 22nd in car number 35 out of Parksville, Kentucky, in the Kaufman Photography Rocket, Todd Kaufman. Starting 21st in car number 121 from Summerall, Mississippi, Lamar Auto Salvage Track Star. Finished 9th in the point standings last year, Michael Blunt. Starting 20th in car number 51, currently 3rd in the point standings out of Gatlinburg, Tennessee, in the CVR Race Cars House Car, Mac McCarter. Starting 19th, currently 2nd in the point standings, car number 19M out of Talladega, Alabama, the Yellowhammer Construction Special for Josh Atkins. Starting 18th in the 17W car from Crossville, Tennessee, in the Wyatt Builder Special, Brett Wyatt. Going 17th in car number 71 out of Knoxville, Tennessee, in the Quality Machine and Welding CVR for Brian Courtney. Starting 16th in car number 56N, he's the Rookie of the Year point leader out of Rainbow City, Alabama, in the Old Man's Garage Special, Chris Noah. Starting 15th, driving the 007 car out of Maryville, Tennessee, the young motorsports warrior, Roger Best. Starting 14th in car number 73 from Ripley, Tennessee, the Greg Sawmill Special, Ashley Newman. Starting on the inside of row 7 in car number 17H from Loudoun, Tennessee, the Mighty Muffler and Brakes CVR for Matt Henderson. Going 12th in car number 87, he's from Forest, Virginia, in the Cecil B. Arthur Beef Farm Special, the current point leader of the Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series with one win on the season, Walker Arthur. Starting 11th in the 8A car, he's from East Ridge, Tennessee, the A-plus Collision Center GRT for Todd Morrow. Starting 10th in car number 5 out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, the defending Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series National Champion, the Hall of Fame inductee in the Neesmith Chevrolet Special, the Chattanooga Flash, Ronnie Johnson. Starting 9th in the 56R car, he's out of Whiteville, Tennessee, in the Rowan Racing Rocket, Jonathan Rowan. Starting 8th in car number 88 from Maryville, Tennessee, the CDE Electric Warrior for Brad Coffey. Starting 7th in car number 52, finished 2nd last night in our main event from Seymour, Tennessee, running the throwback Scott Sexton graphics package in the Brian King Roofing Stinger, Ryan King. Starting 6th in car number 64 out of Murphy, North Carolina, in the Scrappies Metal Special, Jacob Anderson. Starting 5th in car number 29 out of Sevierville, Tennessee, in the Rare Diesel East Tennessee Metal Special, the defending late model champion here at 411 Motor Speedway, Rusty Ballinger. Starting 4th in the RJ1 machine out of Fairmont, West Virginia, the Bland's Towing Rocket for Jared Hawkins. Going 3rd in car number 24 out of Piney Flats, Tennessee, in the Vic Davis Construction TNT Jensen Ford. Moving to the front row on the outside, this is where he started and drove to victory last night here at 411 Motor Speedway. In the J39 car out of Cleveland, Tennessee, the Car Smart Auto Sales CVR for Jimmy Elliott. And your pole sitter tonight with a time of 14.128 seconds in car number 66 out of Knoxville, Tennessee, the Mighty Muffler and Brakes CVR, your fast qualifier and pole sitter tonight, Adam Beeler. That's your starting lineup for tonight's running of the Old Smoky Moonshine 50, round 5 of the 2014 Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series season.
The 44 car of Chase King is under protest. David Miley, second place driver, protested. The 44 Chase King, pending the tire damage.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, before these drivers go green, they have one more thing they'd like to do. Salute you, the great race fans here at 411 Motor Speedway, as they've gone four wide. This time by, ladies and gentlemen, over in tier parking, flash your lights, honk your horns, let them see you. They'll be waving at you over in tier parking. Flash those lights, honk them horns. Everybody on the front straightaway, on your feet. Let's wave your hats, your handkerchiefs, your jackets, your seat cushions. Let them see you. Let them hear you. Here they are, the cars and stars of the Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series. Wave at them. They're waving at you. One of the most beautiful sights in all of motorsports, the four-wide salute to the fans formation. Now the ceremonies have been completed. It's now time to get down to the business at hand. 50 green flag laps of racing with $3,000 awaiting the winner. They go back into their 2x2 flying start formation. Drivers taking one last look at those gauges to make sure they're reading where they should be. Tugging down on those shoulder harnesses one last time, because it is now showtime. Field getting the one to go signal. If everything looks good, we'll go green next time around. Front row cars have been given their starting instructions. They know where the starting box is in turn four between the last Ute tire and that orange cone at the entrance to the infield. Field beginning to bunch up as they enter turn number three. Adam Beeler on the pole position. Jimmy Elliott alongside. They approach the starting box. They're it. They're on it. Green flags out. We're racing. That start did not look good at all, as Adam Beeler did not pick up the pace before Jimmy. Field's been given the one to go signal. Tate Davenport went to the pit area, came back out, still starting at the back of the field. All right, we'll try it again, this time by Adam Beeler, Jimmy Elliott, bringing him into the starting box. They're in it, they're on it, green flags out, we're racing. Beeler takes the lead, Elliott in second, trouble in turn two. Four cars stack them up in turn number two. Caution flag out on the speedway. Chris Noah back out in the 56 car. Went to the pit area. He'll restart on the tail of the field. Evan Taylor up on the hook, headed to the infield. Field will get the one to go signal. Second try at a complete restart. Adam Beeler, Jimmy Elliott up on the front row. Field getting the one to go signal. We'll look for green next time by. Here they come once again into the starting box. Green flags out. Elliott off of two to take the lead. Jensen Ford in third. Hawkins on the outside in fourth, running fifth. It's Jacob Anderson. Trouble in turn two, got one upside down. Turn two's calamity corner tonight. Ballinger involved in the 29 car. Wyatt involved in the 17 car. Brad Coffey in the 88. After taking a nasty flip over in turn number two. So good news for Ryan King. He's okay. Hawkins on the outside in fourth, running fifth. It's Jacob Anderson. Trouble in turn two, got one upside down. Turn two's Calamity Corner tonight. Still getting the field doubled up and bunched up. They'll get the one to go signal this time by. Starter Mark Bales shows him the pearl green flag and gives him the finger. One lap to go before we come back to green. Adam Beeler out in front. He can restart the race anywhere he wants to in turn four. Here they come. Green flag's out. Drive underneath Jimmy Elliott up to second. He'll bring Jacob Anderson with him into third. Caution flag out on the Speedway. Three on the front straightaway, bringing out the caution flag. Seventh will be Rusty Ballinger in car number 29. Ashley Newman up to eighth in car number 73. Ninth will be Walker Arthur in the 87. And in 10th, Jonathan Rowan in the 56R. Field doubled up and ready to go. Jensen Ford chooses the inside for the Dixie-style double file restart. Ford looking to the inside of Beeler down the back straightaway. They're side by side into three. Adam Beeler trying to get the momentum going on the outside. RJ1 car up to third. Caution flag coming out on the Speedway. Got one spun down in the infield in turn two. Jacob Anderson, car number 64, holding down the four spot. And the J39, Jimmy Elliott in fifth. Johnny Johnson trying to move up through the field in car number five. Around Jacob Anderson, up into the fifth spot. Adam Buehler now pulling away from Jensen Ford in second. Kieran Hawkins in third. Jimmy Elliott in fourth. Ronnie Johnson running fifth. Jacob Anderson in sixth. Trouble turn three. Caution flag out. And Courtney spinning in turn three, bringing out his second caution flag of the night. So he'll be done for the evening with the two spin rule in car number 87. That's your top 10 with 10 laps in the books. Jensen Ford chooses the inside for the Dixie style double file restart. Jared Hawkins in the RJ1 car to his right on the outside. Field doubled up behind race leader Adam Buehler in car number 66. Here they come off the fourth turn. Green flags back out. We're racing. Ronnie Johnson up on the outside, challenging Elliott. Caution flag out on the Speedway. Laps in the books. Here they come off of turn four. Johnson up to challenge Jensen Ford for the third spot on the restart. Hooked up back in behind the 24 car off the two down the back straightaway. Caution flag, turn two. Carter tags the wall in turn two. Time around, field doubled up. Hawkins chooses the inside for the Dixie-style double-file restart. Third-place car, Jensen Ford, is right on the outside. Field doubled up behind Buehler. He can pick up the pace anywhere he wants to in turn four. He's on it. Green flag's out. Ronnie Johnson trying to drive underneath Jensen Ford to take over the third spot. Ronnie Johnson up to third. Caution flag coming out. His way up to the 11th spot, spins down the back straightaway to bring out the caution flag. Adam Buehler leads the field into turn number four. Green flags in the air and we're racing. Got a car load up on the high side of turn four. 51, a Mac McCarter. It's time around. 15 laps in the books. Adam Beeler out in front. Jared Hawkins choosing the inside from the second spot for the Dixie Style Double File restart. Third place car, Ronnie Johnson to his right in car number five. Green flags out. Trouble for Jensen Ford in the 24 car. Field getting the one to go signal. We'll try it again. Single file next time around. Adam Beeler still out in front. Jared Hawkins in second. Ronnie Johnson third. Jimmy Elliott back up to the fourth spot. Green flags out. Hawkins looking to the inside of Beeler. Off a two, down the back straightaway. Side by side, up front for the lead. Adam Beeler on the high side will hold the position. Down the front straightaway. caution flag coming out on the Speedway. Matt Henderson in the 17H car spins on the front straightaway to bring out the caution flag. Adam Beeler still out in front. That'll erase a half straightaway lead. Field lined up and ready to go. If everything looks good, we'll go green next time around. 31 laps in the books, 19 to go. Down to complete lap number 40. 10 laps to go. Ronnie Johnson trying to put some pressure on Jared Hawkins right in that second spot. Johnson beginning to take a peek at the inside of Hawkins. Adam Beeler down the back straightaway, working lap traffic, working to the inside of Michael Blunt in the 121 car. Coming down to complete lap number 49. White flag in the air, one lap to go for Adam Beeler. Beeler with some clear racetrack in front of him. Down the back straightaway into turn number three. Ronnie Johnson on the outside, getting around Jared Hawkins on the final lap. Beeler takes the win. Johnson second, Hawkins third. Elliott fourth, and Ashley Newman will finish fifth. So Adam Beeler goes wire to wire to pick up his first career Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series career win. And we'll head down to the front straightaway to have a word with our winner.
Oh, it is. We've come up here past 2 years and we sit on the pole, sit on the outside pole. We've led races, just had bad luck. And to come out here and win tonight means a lot.
Well, it was a pretty rough evening for everybody behind you, but your car looks like it doesn't have a scratch on it. Pretty uneventful evening for you. Looked like you just had it on cruise control.
Yeah, the car was pretty good. I wasn't sure where Ronnie and them were, but I like Raceman Ronnie. He's fun. But yeah, we tore up enough stuff last night, so glad to bring it home one piece tonight.
Well, it's got to feel good to finally get one of these under your belt, and you're keeping the money at home, $3,000.
Oh, yeah, that helps a lot. You know, it's expensive traveling around and just week to week. But I'd like to thank CVR Race Cars, Matlock Decals, HVH, AR Bodies, Old Man's Garage, Mighty Muffler, Bill Bunch, Phantom. If it wasn't for them guys, we couldn't do this at all.
Well, Adam, congratulations on your first career Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series win. Your winner tonight out of Knoxville, Tennessee, Adam Beeler. And here's a couple of drivers talking over their battle for the second spot. But when it's all said and done, the Chattanooga Flash, Ronnie Johnson, comes home with second. Well, Ronnie, I tell you, second place tonight kind of got off to a slow start this season, but it looks like you got the five car rolling now.
Well, I don't know. When I qualified tonight, I was just being way too cautious and put us behind. I felt like we had a pretty decent car. It showed that in hot laps, but I didn't get it out of it qualifying. Just it takes me a while to get her wound up now, but I kept wanting to jump up there and run that top line for the whole race, and finally, you know, my guy told me I had some room, and we had two laps to go, so I tried it. I should have been up there earlier, but appreciate the fans coming out tonight. Really do, man. We got to have y'all to watch us and support us so we can all have, you know, enjoy this passion that we love. Thanks again to them and all of Neesmith Chevrolet, the series, and the racetracks again, 411 Speedway. Had a good racy racetrack tonight like they always do.
Well, Ronnie, second place finish tonight. Going to put you right back in that championship hunt as you look for your second straight Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series championship.
We definitely have got off to a slow start, but I saw some of the guys in the top five in the points had trouble tonight, struggled and had trouble, and that's the key to this thing. You just got to stay consistent, stay out of trouble. So, you know, but I'm really tickled to get a second place finish. We haven't won one this year. It's time to pick it up and get it done.
All right, Ronnie Johnson, second place tonight out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. Here's a young driver here from Fairmont, West Virginia, that came to race with us first time with the Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series. Your third place finish here tonight, Jared Hawkins. Jared, what do you think of 411 Motor Speedway?
First time down here. It's a great facility, awesome track, and I really enjoyed it.
And I tell you, racing with one of the best in the business right there, a National Dirt Late Model Hall of Fame inductee, Ronnie Johnson. And, you know, when you go toe-to-toe with him, you got to come away learning something.
Absolutely. I grew up watching him. I'd go to Pennsboro for the Dirt Track World Championship, and I was always a big fan of his. So just to get to run with him, that was awesome. And, yeah, he's great. So, but I'm real happy with the third. Jerry Haslew, a good friend of my dad's, invited me to come down here. My brother been running this car early in the season. And he had some things come up, so this was my second crate race. It took us a little bit yesterday trying to get this thing freed up, but today we started from where we ended yesterday, and I think we had a pretty good finish.
All right, congratulations on a third-place finish. Jared Hawkins, your third-place finisher tonight in the Old Smoky Moonshine 50.